Hi, how are you going? I hope you're feeling as well as possible on your medicines. I'm Pharmacist Fi, and this is Denver. Welcome to our Medicine Safety YouTube channel and to this episode of How Does That Work? In this video, I'd like to tell you about the very clever way a medicine called allopurinol works for people who have gout. Then we'll look at five important ways you can try to get allopurinol treatment success and minimize your risk of rare, potentially serious side effects. And by treatment success, I mean never getting a gout flare again, ever, which we'll talk about shortly. Before we can understand how allopurinol works, we need to know how gout happens. Two main things happen to cause a painful gout attack, which may also be called an acute gout flare. The first thing is that if we have a high uric acid level, which may also be called a urate level, for some people, having a high uric acid level may lead to gout urate crystals being laid down in one or more joints, soft tissues, and or kidneys. The second thing is that if we have a combination of a sudden change in our uric acid level, which could either be an increase or decrease, the combination of a change in uric acid level and having gout urate crystals may trigger some of our immune system cells to behave the way they would if they were attacking bacteria. And unfortunately, this involves some friendly fire damaging our own cells in the part of the body where the gout urate crystals are, which causes the severe pain and inflammation of gout attacks. So where does allopurinol fit into this picture? Allopurinol is a urate lowering medicine, which means it reduces our uric acid level. The very clever way allopurinol does this is by blocking enzymes called xanthine oxidase enzymes, which may also be called xanthine oxidoreductase. And in case you're wondering what an enzyme is, it's a type of protein that controls how fast one or more chemical reactions can happen in our body. Now, what xanthine oxidase enzymes usually do is to break down the remains of old purines. Purines are tiny natural substances in our body that used to either be part of DNA or used to help transfer energy around our cells. So xanthine oxidase breaks down these purine remainder substances called hypoxanthine and xanthine into uric acid and free radicals. So by blocking the xanthine oxidase enzymes, allopurinol reduces how much uric acid our body makes. So that is how allopurinol reduces our uric acid level. Allopurinol is not an anti-inflammatory medicine. So in the first 6 months or more of allopurinol treatment, while the gout urate crystals are still being melted, most people with gout will also need to take a different type of medicine to try to prevent the inflammation and pain of acute gout flares. Because gout flares only stop happening once all the gout urate crystals have been melted. The most commonly used types of anti-inflammatory medicines for gout are colchicine, or non-steroidal anti-inflammatories like indomethacin or ibuprofen, or corticosteroids like prednisone or prednisolone. But make sure that you only take a medicine from one of these categories if a doctor has advised you to do so, because some people must not take one or more categories of these anti-inflammatory medicines due to potentially life-threatening interactions with some other medicines or some other medical conditions. Just before I start sharing five ways to try to achieve allopurinol treatment success, if anything I am about to say sounds different from what you have been advised to do, talk with a doctor as soon as possible to get their advice about whether what I say in this video may or may not be suitable for you, and only make medicine decisions together with a doctor. Okay, five things for helping with allopurinol treatment success. Number one, to reduce our risk of potentially life-threatening rare side effects like drug reactions, and to reduce our risk of gout flares, allopurinol should be started on a low dose. And then allopurinol dose should be increased gradually by small amounts over a period of months up to a personalized maintenance dose. And a maintenance dose is the dose needed to keep that person's uric acid level consistently at target level. Number two, different people will need a different allopurinol dose, if allopurinol is suitable for them, to reduce their uric acid level down to the target level. First of all, to melt the gout crystals, and then to prevent gout crystals from ever reforming. If uric acid is kept at target level, melting gout urate crystals may take 6 months or more for people with no TOFI, or may take 12 months or more for people with TOFI. And in case you're wondering, TOFI are lumps of gout crystals that may be big enough to see or feel. I will put some info about these modern allopurinol dose schedules and uric acid target levels into the description section of this video for doctors, which you are very welcome to share with your doctor so you can ask the doctor whether it may or may not apply to you. Number three, if you have gout and a doctor has put you on a set dose of allopurinol and has not adjusted your dose based on uric acid level blood tests, ask your doctor about getting uric acid level blood test to help you get a personalised allopurinol dose. And if possible, it is better to do the uric acid level blood test when you don't have a gout flare or an infection, because uric acid level is often lower during a gout flare and uric acid level may be higher than usual during an infection. Number four, once our allopurinol maintenance dose is reached, we need to try to take allopurinol consistently the way the doctor advises us to take it, by doing things like setting alarms on our mobile phone or some other device to help us remember doses. And this is really worth doing because it helps our uric acid level to be more consistently at target level. For example, stopping allopurinol during a gout flare will usually make a gout flare worse and or last longer, because stopping allopurinol changes our uric acid level suddenly. So don't stop allopurinol during a gout flare unless you get a potentially serious side effect or a doctor advises you specifically to stop your allopurinol. And I'll put a link to my video with info about side effects for you into the description section of this video. Number five, allopurinol has some significant medicine interactions, so it is a good idea to ask your doctor or pharmacist to please run an interactions check for you of everything you take versus allopurinol. And if any medicine interactions are found, immediately ask your doctor whether any medicine changes may be needed or not. I hope the info in this video has been helpful for you, and I'll put links into the description section for you to my shorts video playlist called 10 Things You May Not Know About Gout, which I also highly recommend viewing. If you have any questions about anything I've said in this video, you're very welcome to ask them in the comments section below. Please click the subscribe and like buttons below this video if you'd like to see more of these medicine safety videos. And Denver and I look forward to catching up with you again very soon here on this PHARMACIST Fi Medicine Safety YouTube channel. Thanks for watching. Bye.